things. And the first conversation I would actually like everyone to come to the table today is this relatively new but relatively cliche jargon called experience. You know, we're actually entering the world, we've entered the world of brand experiences. The entire socio-cultural mechanisms, entire marketing creative mechanisms are designed towards creating experiences, which Ravinder just spoke about. And I think every accomplished panelist here in their own ways are actually fueling experiences. Rajiv, be it in terms of sound, Mahesh in terms of the banking experience, Gunjan, the work we do with talent, Pooja, of course, in terms of, you know, conversations and culture creation that each of you are doing. So I just want to understand from you and just make it very freewheeling in terms of what really is your worldview of experience? Is it a cliche? Is it jargon? And how does the brand narrative change from product plus communication towards an integrated experience? Open to all.
No, if I could go first, brand experience is really number one for every brand today. Because if you don't have that in place, you're not going to be able to deliver anything beyond great communication. Because you may have a great ad, but if just your customer experience sucks, that's it, you lost the customer. It doesn't matter how smart your creative idea is. So that's number one. It's very, very important. And it's important for every brand manager, along with all of the creative data, media, technology partners they work with, that it all strings together, that we're all speaking the same language, the experience that is promised in communication actually gets delivered on ground. And that is not just something that you would get in store, but on app, what you would get in the form of delivery, what you would get in the form of actual product usage. So that piece has to be extremely consistent. And data today allows you to see where you're faltering and be able to make corrections very, very quickly. Because if you may have a great ad, but immediately the moment it is on app for sale, say for example, on an Amazon store, and someone points out to you that this did not work for me, you have the power to change it very, very quickly. Then wait for 6 months till you actually got information and then make a change, et cetera, right? So that's very, very important. And the marriage of data plus constant listening is helping make brands' lives easier, in my view.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Anybody else would like to add to this?
Yeah, so if I may go, we touched upon, I think earlier, in the introductory statements, something about consumers getting bored of advertising, right? I think what's happening is that there's two things that are happening. One is the sheer intrusion of when you're on, a digital interface and, an ad pops in and, you're watching something else. The second is, I think over time, the past decade, has not been particularly good for brands in the sense of a certain equity, honesty quotient. A lot of brands have let their consumers down, whether it's through product failures or corruption or various other things. So this notion of brand loyalty, right? I don't think it exists. So consumers are saying, hey man, I don't believe you intrinsically, You're trying to sell something to me. So I think that's where experience really starts playing a role. Because brands, especially in these times, right, it's even more important that brands behave honestly, sincerely. And, everything is not about selling. So you've got to, to change your tone to, I read a fascinating article that the sound of birds in New York City, the birds are singing differently, right? Because there is so much silence, the birds no longer need to shout louder to get their bird calls heard. So they're much more mellow and sweet. So I think brands have to follow that example. And that links into how they create experiences. Experiences, therefore, have got to be much more honest, much more sincere, more subtle, not so branded, right? And we are finding that that's great for the nascent category that Sonic was. It's really catapulting Sonic into the subliminal, experiential kind of space. So I think really the experience is the word. So we've actually started a new division called Brand Music XP, which is, of course, stands for